Good morning, students. Last video, we have discussed the details of automated teller machine, uses, then features, advantages, disadvantages, and applications of ATM. Today, we will see the next topic, the digital camera. A digital camera is a hardware device that takes the photographs and shows the images as data on a memory card. Unlike an analog camera which exposes film chemicals to light, a digital camera uses digital optical components to register the intensity and color of light and convert into pixel data. Many digital cameras are capable of recording video in addition to taking photos. A camera that is always connected to your computer with no storage could also be referred to as a digital camera. However, it is a more appropriate to refer to this device as webcam. A digital camera may be considered both an input and output device, as it can both take picture, that is input, and send them to the computer, that is output. See, this is the part of the camera. So this is another slide. So this is also part of the camera and functions. Let's see one by one the parts function. The first one, that is a viewfinder. The viewfinder is one of the most important part of the camera. It is a rectangular shaped part at the back of your camera that lets you see and frame your subject. Some viewfinder are fully digital, which shows you various details like your shutter speed, aperture and ISO before you take the shoot. Then pentaprism. Pentaprism is a mirror placed at a 45 degree angle behind the camera lens. The mirror projects the light captured from the lens to the viewfinder. Before the pentaprism were introduced, photographers always had to look downwards when taking photos, which is not ideal for some subjects and would only allow you to take the photos at hip level. Pentaprism got rid of this problem and now defines single lens reflex or SLR cameras. Then third part, that is a focusing screen. A camera's focusing screen is a glass surface on which the camera's mirror project the image. The focusing screen helps in achieving various focus effect such as a sharp and a high contrast shoot or blur and bokeh. Then fourth one is a condenser lens. Condenser lens is a part made up of two matching convex lens. This part uses a simple method for correcting color fringing or aberration. That is a common problem encountered when using traditional camera lenses. Then fifth part, that is a digital camera. Fifth part is a digital sensor. A digital sensor of a camera is one of the most delicate parts. The sensor captures the light coming from the lens to create an image. Modern cameras use either a charge coupled device, that is a CCD, or a complementary metal oxide semiconductor, that is a CMOS imager, for capturing images. The next one, that is a shutter. Camera shutter is an opaque piece of metal or plastic that controls the amount of light that reaches the camera sensor. The length of which your shutter stays open will determine how your exposure will look like. So, you can activate this using the shutter release button and adjust it accordingly using your camera's shutter speed setting. Then display. The camera display shows the user helpful information about the photos and camera. Here, you will see the different camera settings. You can tweak to alter your exposure, ISO, shutter speed and more. You can also access other menus using this display to change the settings on your camera. Most camera displays nowadays let you see them how your image will appear before you press the shutter release button. This feature revolutionized digital camera as it helps photographers in creating consistent shot. The next component, that is electronics. Camera's electronic component can be divided into three separate categories: photo capture components, camera controller and user interface components. The camera controller elements control all the electronic components of the camera. Its photo capture elements are responsible for the recording of images, while the user interface elements are responsible for letting the user interact with and control the camera. The next part, that is the autofocus system. One of the advantages of a digital camera have over traditional film camera is the ability to focus on a particular subject quickly and automatically. This is made possible thanks to autofocus sensor. One of the part of the camera lens that sends information to the computer inside the camera and command the lens to adjust its focusing elements to render a sharp image. The next part, that is a reflex and a relay mirror. The reflex mirror is found in any SLR, that is a single lens reflex, or DSLR, that is a digital single lens reflex camera. SLR refers to a camera with a single lens and a reflex mirror to bend the light path to the optical viewfinding for framing. A DSLR is a digital SLR, meaning it has a digital sensor to record images. Digital SLR have many advantages compared to the film counterparts. Unlike rangefinder camera, the lens of the DSLR camera is not on the same axis as the lens, which is why this type of camera needs a mirror. The reflex mirror is a mirror positioned at a 45 degree angle to reflect the light from the lens to the viewfinder, enabling you to see what the lens sees. Then aperture. So aperture is considered to be one of the three pillars of the determining exposure of your photograph. The aperture is the opening in your camera lens through which light passes through. This part is made up of small thin blades that shrink or expand depending on how much light you want in your exposure. It also determines the depth of the field of your camera, which is a vital factor in how much background blur you want. Then zoom elements. If you just bought your first ever camera, chances are you got a zoom lens with it. Zoom lenses allow you to shift between focal length from wide to telephoto, depending on your lens focal range by turning the lens rings. Then batteries. Battery is one of the most important part of the camera, as most of its components will not work if not powered by one. Having a long lasting battery lets you shoot more photos and shoot for extended periods, allowing you to find the perfect shot. The next slide. The next slide, that is see the specification under this. The first one is a CCD array. Camera records the picture using a charge coupled device, that is a CCD array. Then the array consisting of a large number of horizontal rows and vertical columns of CCD cells for the picture. A number of CCD cells unexposed to the picture in each row of cells, but those used of a set of correction in each row output from the picture cells. The second one is camera picture resolution, 2592 by 1944 pixels. That is 2592 by 1944 pixels. There are 50,38,848 set of cells available. Each set of pixel has three cells for the red, green, and blue components in a pixel. Each cell gets exposed to a picture when shutter of camera opens on a user command. Then controller, LCD display, switches and buttons. A set of controllers is used to control the shutter, flash, autofocus and eyeball image control. LCD display for graphics and GUI. GUI means graphical user interface. It is a system on interface, visual components for computer software. Yeah, GUI display objects that convey information and represent actions that can be taken by the user. The objects change color, size or visibility when the user interact with them. Then switches and buttons for input at the camera. User gives a command for switching on the camera. Flash, shutter, adjust brightness, contrast, color, save and transfer. When a button for opening the shutter is pressed, a flash lamp glows and a self timer circuit switches off the lamp automatically. Then a picture transfer port, JPEG file for a picture can be copied or transferred to a memory stick using a controller. Sony memory stick micro, that is M2. The size is 15 by 12.5 by 1.2 mm. Flash memory of 2 GB and 160 megabits per second data transfer range. A picture JPG can be copied to a computer connected through USB port controller. Then what are the requirements? The first one is a purpose. The first requirement is purpose. Digital recording and display of pictures. Then processing to get the pictures of the required brightness, contrast and color. Then permanent saving of picture in file in a standard format at a flash memory stick or card. Then transfer files to a computer and printer through USB port. So these are the requirements under purpose. Then the second requirement is inputs. So here intensity and color values for each picture, horizontal and vertical rows and columns of the pixel in a picture frame. Intensity and color values of the unexposed area in each horizontal row and column of the pixel. User control inputs. So these are the requirements needed for inputs. Then third one, signals, events and notifications. Here user command given as signals from switches or buttons. Then fourth requirement, output. That is encode file for a picture. Then permanent store of the picture at a file on flash memory stick. Then screen display of picture from the file after decoding. Then file output to an interface, the computer and printer. So this is about requirements of outputs. Then next one, functions of the system. So here a color LCD dot matrix display the picture before shooting and enables manual adjustment of the view of the picture. Then for shooting, a shutter button press, a charge coupled device, that is a CCD array, plays at the focus, generate a byte stream in output after operation by ADC and analog output of each CCD cell. So a file creates after encoding. Encoding is nothing but a compression and pixel co-processing. Then the byte stream is pre-processed and then encoded in a standard format using QADAC. CODEC. Then the encoded picture file saved for a permanent record. A memory stick saves the file. The file is used for display of a record picture using a display processor and can be copied or transferred to a memory stick and to a computer or a printer connecting through USB port. Then LCD display picture file, after it is decoded using codec, that is CODEC, test such as a picture title, shooting date and time and serial numbers are also displayed. USB port is used for transferring and storing pictures on a computer. Alternatively, Bluetooth or IR port can be used for interfacing the computer. Okay, then the next requirement, that is the design matrices. Power dissipation. The first one is a power dissipation. Battery operation, that is a battery recharging after 400 pictures. This is an assumption. Then resolution, high resolution pictures with the option of 2592 by 1944 pixels needed. So this is the high resolution, that is 3.2 megapixel. Suppose 2048 by 1536, that is 3 megapixel. Or 1280 by 960, that is 1 megapixel. Then third one is a performance. Shooting a 4 megapixel still picture is 0.5 seconds, 25 pictures per minute. So this is also assumption. Then process deadlines. Exposing camera process maximum 0.1 second. Flash synchronous with the shutter operating and the closing. Then picture display latency maximum 0.5 second. Then user interface, that is a graphics at LCD or a touch screen display on LCD, and command by camera user through fingers on touch, that is a command by a camera user through fingers on touch screen and switches and buttons. Then cost, that is a cost of a camera and a manufacturing cost, approximately 5000, more than 5000. So these points are considered under design matrices. Then the next requirement, that is a test and a validation conditions. So here all user command must function correctly. All graphic display and menus should appear as per the program. Then each task should be tested with a test input. Then tested for 30 pictures per minute. So these are the requirements under test and validation condition. The next one is class diagram. So in class diagram, first we consider the camera task. So camera tasks are modeled by four class diagrams. They are divided by picture file creation, picture file display, picture file transfer and control task. Class diagram for file creation, display and transfer. Here digital camera file creation, then display and transfer to printer, memory stick and USB port can be modeled by the class diagram of abstract class picture file creation, picture file design and picture file transfer. The next one, camera task. So here camera task are modeled by four class diagram. The first one is a picture file creation, second one picture file display, third one picture file transfer and fourth one controller task. Then the next slide shows the class diagram for file creation, display and transfer. That is a digital camera file creation, display and transferring to printer, memory stick and USB port can be modeled by the class diagram of the abstract class. Here, picture file creation, then picture file display, then picture file transfer needed for that. The next slide shows class diagram picture. See here in this diagram, first exposed area CCD bytes stream, then dark area CCD bytes stream. Okay, then for that create a file creation for picture file creation. So this is one process. Another process, task CCD preprocessor, then task after that task picture processor, then task encoding, then after that task save. So this is another process. Similarly, picture file display, for that task decoding, task display processor, then task display. So these are the process for display. Then for picture file transfer, either a printer or USB port or memory stick. So this is the class diagram for digital camera. Okay, then task object. So here instances of the classes, that is the exposure area CCD byte stream, data area CCD byte stream, task CCD preprocessor, task picture processor, task encoding. So these are the task objects. Then controller task. Here controller task, that is a task initialization, task shoot, then initiate a CCD processor, that is CCDP, to initialize a picture file creation, to initiate a picture file display task, which run on initiation of a display process, then initiate ASIP memory save, then initiate ASIP for printer, then initiate ASIP for USB, then task control for light level, then task flash. So these are the controller task. Then the next topic is digital camera hardware architecture. See here, see the architecture. So this microcontroller contains CPU, memory, that is a RAM type memory, as well as a flash memory, that is a ROM. Okay, in addition with ports also available, USB ports available, okay, to the computer. Okay, then it is also connected to multiplexer and analog to digital converter, then CCD array. Then here another option, that is from ADC to CCDP, then printer option available or display option available, otherwise the images will be stored in memory. Okay, so this is also available. Suppose a display means either LCD printer, that is a dot matrix display controller is used. Suppose a memory means a flash memory stick is used. So this is about digital camera hardware architecture. The next slide shows the software architecture. So here two layers available. The first one is upper layer and second one is lower layers. See the first layer, that is upper layer. So the upper layer, it contains system layer, application layer and function layer. So three layers available under upper layer. The system layer contains system services, for example display text with the picture, flash, start and stop after timeout, often auto timer, then saving and retrieving process, retrieving of a processor internal registers, the operating system services such as IPC, inter-process communication. So these are all system layer. Then next one is application layer. Okay, that is a system switches, buttons, control task. So example, flash light, contrast, image view before shooting. So this is about application layer. Then next one, function layer. For application layer, task functionally using picture file creation, picture file display, and picture file transfer. So this is about upper layers. Then lower layers, this is also contains three types of layers. The first one is a presentation layer, then control layer, then base layer. The first layer, that is a presentation layer, contains a standard access to image file. Examples, default setting of image contrast, resolution and outputs, display color setting, sound of a click, time and date display, dot matrix or touch screen driver, ADC output format and data output. So these are all presentation layer. Then second one, that is a control layer. So here control task, that is a timer control and a real time control modules available. Then base layer contains a standard access to the internal devices in the microcontroller. Internal device example, that is a timer, real time clock, then serial interface, then ADC, USB port. So these are all base layers. Then the next slide shows the modeling of a synchronization of task part 1. See here, so this is shoot the picture, then picture file creation, then picture file creation task, picture process, then after that exposure area, CCD byte stream. Then if it is not clear, means again do the same process, otherwise it moves to the next one, that is a dark area, CCD byte stream. Then after that it moves to the task CCD preprocessor, that is a byte stream. Then after that task encoding, then that picture will be saved. So this is modeling of a synchronization of task part 1. Then part 2, see here, picture file display. Then after that, that will be decoded. Then that will be displayed in any one of the display mode. Okay. Then picture file transfer. Transfer means either printer or USB port or memory stick. So this is modeling of a synchronization of task part 2. Okay. Then this is the architecture of digital still camera. Most camera uses two processors, the controller sequence operation on the camera and performs operation like file system management. So DSP concentrate on image processing. DSP may be either a programmable processor or a set of hardware accelerator. So accelerator are often used to the minimize power consumption. Okay. So so this is about architecture. Then next diagram, that is a sequence diagram for taking a picture with a digital camera. So here, what are the phases available? The first one is the user, second one controller, third one image processor, fourth one imager, fifth one display, then after that storage. Okay. So the picture taking process can be divided into three main phases: composition, capture and storage. The process of taking a picture with a digital still camera can be clearly understood with the steps here illustrated here. When the camera is turned on, it must start to display the image on the camera screen. That image comes from the camera's image sensor. To provide a reasonable image, it must adjust the image exposure. Then the camera mechanism provides two basic exposure controls. One is a shutter speed and aperture. The camera also displays what is seen through the lens on the camera display. In general, the display has fewer pixels than does the image sensor. The image processor must generate a smaller version of the image. When the user depresses the shutter button, that is, once again press the shutter button, a number of steps occur. The first step is before the image is captured, the final exposure must be determined. Then the exposure is computed by analyzing the image characteristics, histogram of the distribution of the pixel, brightness are often used to determine focus. Then the camera must also determine the white balance. Then different sources of light such as sunlight, incandescent lamp provides light of different colors. The eye naturally compensate for the color of incident light. The camera must perform comparable processing to avoid giving the picture a color cast. Then white balance algorithm generally use a color histogram to determine the range of the colors and re-weight colors to reduce cast. So the next slide, that is the image captured from the image sensor is not directly usable even after exposure and white balance. So virtually all still cameras use a single image sensor to capture a color image. So color is captured using microscopic color filters. Each the size of the pixel over the image sensor. Since each pixel can capture only one color, the color filter must be arranged in a pattern across the image sensor. A commonly used pattern is the Bayer pattern. See the slide. So this pattern uses two greens for every red and blue pixel. Since the human eye is the most sensitive to green, the camera must interpolate colors so that every pixel has a red, green and blue values. So after this image processing is complete, the image must be compressed and saved. So images are often compressed in a JPEG format, but other formats such as GIF may also be used. Image compression need not be performed strictly in real time. Mini camera allows user to take a burst of images, in which case the image must be compressed quickly to make room in the image processing pipeline for the next image. Buffering is very important in digital still camera. Image processing often takes longer than capturing an image. User often want to take a burst of several pictures, for example during a sports events, etc. A buffer memory is used to capture the image from the sensor and store it until it can be processed by the DSP processor. Then the display is often connected to the DSP rather than the system bus, because the display is of a lower resolution than the image sensor. The images from the image sensor must be reduced in resolution. Many still cameras use a display originally designed for camcorders, so the DSP may also need to clip the image to accommodate the different aspect ratios of the display and image sensor. So far we have seen digital camera architecture, uses, then parts, details, and we have come to the end of the unit 5. Thank you.